I brought along my son Jonathan, who in the year 2001 will be the same age as I am now. Maybe he will be better adjusted to this kind of world that you're trying to portray.
Oh, there's a dad coming away.
In fact, if we wanted to wait for the year 2001, he said he will have in his own house, not a computer as big as this, but at least a console through which he can talk to his friendly local computer and get all the information he needs for his everyday life.
Sometimes I don't.
That nigga's stupid. Get him some milk.
Why can't the y'all do? I got a private motor.
Take a whole team.
Jump by you.
Hit him with that bloody pop pop pop.
Got a bull, got a pop, got a bam.
Hit it. Yeah, there you go.
Are you Bolo?
I was playing with the new operators yesterday. Oh my gosh, that's so complicated.
Damn, you know how your aim assist is?
Modern society. This will be in a compact form in his own house. He'll have a television screen like this here and a keyboard, and he'll talk to the computer, get information from it, and he'll take it as much for granted as we take the telephone.
I wonder, though, what sort of a life would it be like in social terms? I mean, if our whole life is built around the computer, do we become a computer-dependent society and a computer-independent individuals?
In some ways, but they'll also enrich our society because it'll make it possible for us to live really anywhere we like. Any businessman, any executive could live almost anywhere on Earth and still do his business through a device like this. And this is a wonderful thing. It means we want him to be stuck in cities, we better live out in the country or wherever we please, and still carry on complete interaction with human beings as well as with other computers.
Just in a-